All right, guys, we're live on camera, so everything's going to be picked up. So if you don't mind things being on YouTube forever, keep on talking. And all right, so asked a question on money, yeah, and taking a leap, yeah, around that, and how to let go. Well, for me, the thing with money's a more interesting one, because there's so many collective belief systems and personal belief systems around money. And there is both the belief systems around money, there you can cancel your own personal belief systems around money, you can cancel your fears around money, you can also cancel collective ideas around money, also you want to clear out any residual fear or anxiousness that you're holding around money. Also, you're holding, because it's a thing of like faith, it's like the future. You also want to hand over the future around money. So there's a lot of belief systems that you want to be, you want to get so that, and I would get like a, you know, get a piece of paper or a couple of pieces of paper, and over the next week, or an ongoing thing of every belief system you have around money, and work, and getting work, and the future. Remember, the Course in Miracles says the source of abundance is actually your connection to God. So God is the source of money, funny enough. But your limiting beliefs, that your personal limiting beliefs and the collective belief systems around money block off God giving you money. And the problem with money, because a lot of spiritual seekers ask money, is that actually we've got a lot of baggage. In this Western society, you have so many belief systems around money that it's a fair amount of... So you want to like write down everything you think. You might even go on... I once did this, actually. You might even go and just find what are the normal belief systems people have. If you go on Google, like usual belief systems, limited belief systems around money, you probably get like loads and loads of pages. Like, you should cancel your belief in... I cancel my belief money doesn't grow in trees. I cancel my belief that I have to work hard and work to death and earn whatever it is before I can make money. So you'll see there's so many belief systems you want to cancel. Then as you think about making money and getting money easily, you'll see like your ideas will come into mind. Like, no, that can't be easy. There can't be flow. Oh, actually, probably if I do get a job, I'll be on the minimum wage. So you'll see your own belief systems come up. Just as you try and visualize your money coming in, you'll see all your negative belief systems will come up. It's going to be difficult. I'm going to starve, actually, before I get a job. I'll probably get a minimum wage. So all of this stuff. So you're writing down all your belief systems, putting them in. If you think about money, and then also sometimes read your belief systems, think about money, think about the future of money, and just try and feel the feelings. Like if you feel any anxiety or fear coming up, then just feel that out. So feel out any residual. Think about, or even you can visualize like the worst possible outcome. Like you're never going to get another job, and then you won't be able to, and then you'll be on the streets, and you'll be homeless, and then you'll die, without any money. So if that brings up a charge, then you can sit with that and feel it out. Just feel out those feelings. Or the fear of not being able to make your mortgage payments if you don't get enough money. So all of those things, you know, I cancel my belief, I cancel my fear I won't make enough money to pay the mortgage installments. I'm an infinite being. I cancel my belief money doesn't grow in trees. I cancel my belief that I have to work hard for little money. You know, I'm an infinite being. So all of these belief systems, the problem is, like, if you go to the observer and feel the feelings, you probably still haven't cancelled all your beliefs around money, so you can feel quite peaceful, you know, just doing the observer and feel the feelings and feel like very abundant. But actually you might still find money's not flowing. And that's because you've still got a lot of collective belief systems in there, stuck in there. So just keep putting them on. Remember the Course in Miracles, have a long list, and if it's something you want to work on as an assignment, and especially if finances is the thing that's coming up for you, I would like have your list of money belief systems and do them every day, or even do them like 10, 20, 100 times a day,
And when you say do them, what is that, cancel them?
Cancel them or place them into God's infinite light and love and pray for miracles and trust. Both of them, I cancel my belief money doesn't grow on trees, I'm an infinite being. I cancel is like I refute this belief system. This belief system does not, I cancel it. In the name of God, I cancel the belief system. I'm an infinite being, and then I'm in the infinite light. So you wash out that belief system into the infinite light of God. So that's one way of doing it. Or I place my belief money doesn't grow on trees into God's infinite light and love. So you just dissolve it in God's infinite light and love and pray for miracles and transcendence. Transcendence means you completely erase it. You've transcended holding on to that idea, which is a limited belief system. As you do this over the days, you'll know you're making great progress when you get this feeling like, you know, you get this feeling like, whatever happens, I know I'll be taken care of. It's like, I don't know why I have any fear about money. There is like there's like the presence of God, and that's looking after me, and I have no fear. And you have this bulletproofness. And when you have, always when I'm in that vibration in the situation, like this infinite bulletproofness around it, it always goes well, guaranteed. It's like, you know, the grace of God is with you and nothing can touch you, and that's true. You're invincible in that place.
I had a sense of that this week. I don't remember what it was, and it didn't even really matter what it was or what was happening. I think it was near the start of the day, but I literally had this sense of like moving through, you know, just walking,
yes,
moving through time and space, and it was, everything was just perfect. And there was, yeah, maybe it was, I don't know what it was, but there was, yeah, just this sense of like, there were no fears and there was no worry, and I was, yeah, just so fully present in those moments. It was, yeah, it was like bliss.
Yeah, the bliss thing, okay, so when you're in bliss, nothing will touch you.
Yeah.
But if you come, like, if you suddenly see, like, you suddenly look at your bank statements, the bliss should still be there, you know. And as you have to, as the bills come in, is the bliss is still there, you're doing really well. If you're sitting alone in an ashram or in a cathedral in your bliss, it's good. But that bliss must also be maintained throughout the day and through all situations. Mm-hmm. But if you lose the bliss every time you see your bank statement or your bills, there's a bit more work to do. So that's the thing. It's just like, you know, if there's a person you're in conflict with, being in bliss when they're not in the room is quite easy, you know. But if you're still in bliss when they're in the room, then, you know, you've more or less transcended.
Yeah, you know what? I think I was going to work. That's what it was.
Yes.
And I had, because I remember there was something I was a bit connecting, thinking, oh yeah, this is really amazing because this is happening in this context.
Yeah.
And I had just this sense of it's all fine, even though I'd had so much distress around this situation previously. So there was something, I don't know what it was that had happened that meant I didn't have all that stuff going on. And I just felt such ease.
It's a very good sign. If in a difficult situation you're also feeling bliss, it's a good sign that you're almost there. Because when you if you can maintain the bliss in a difficult situation, then it means you've probably transcended most of the baggage. Might be a bit of tweaking. Yeah. So that's a very good sign. Yeah. That's what I would do. Yeah.
Thank you.